Hello children, in this video we are going to do networking fundamentals. Computer network. Now what is computer network? A computer network is a collection of computers and other hardware components interconnected by communication channels like cables or satellites that allow sharing of resources and information. So computer network is what? It is the collection of computers, right? Collection of computers, and the computers are connected to each other. Not only computers are connected, we have other hardware devices, other hardware components which are connected to that network, right? Means computers kya hai? Ek dusre se connected hai. Okay? And apart from computers, we have other hardware components which are connected in that network. Right, so you can see in the picture. Okay, see here, the internet is provided to the modem, and through the modem it is provided to the switch. Right, switch is connected to the server, and this is connected to the printer, and it is also, the switch is providing connection to the client's computer, right? It is also providing connection to the wireless router, okay? And the wireless router is giving wireless connection to the devices, right? So in this picture, you can see the network. All the computers, all the devices are connected, right? Okay, and they are using a network, that is internet. Fine. So computer network is the connection of the computers and devices, right? Okay. Now next we have computer network architecture. Computer network architecture means how we arrange the computers, okay, in a network. How we are going to arrange them in a network. So here we have peer-to-peer or P2P architecture. What is P2P architecture? Networks in which all computers have an equal status are called peer-to-peer network. Wo network jisme sare ke sare computers equal hai, right? They have equal capability are peer-to-peer network. Generally in such a network, each terminal has an equally competent CPU, okay? And they work as a terminal. Right, okay, so they are basically used for transferring data from one computer to the another computer, right? So you can take example of the computers in your computer labs, okay, where all the computers are connected to each other, right? And you can transfer your file from one computer to the another, okay? So in peer-to-peer network, all the computers are equal and all can transfer their data, their resources from one computer to the another, right? Next computer architecture is client-server architecture. Networks in which certain computers have special dedicated tasks providing services to other computers in the network are called client-server networks. The computers which provide services are called servers, and the one that use these services are called clients, right? So in client-server architecture, one computer which provides services to the other computer is called a server, and the computer which receives the services, which takes services from the servers, are called as clients. In this, you can take example of your smart classes, right? I think in most of the schools, we used to teach with smart classes, right? So what the teacher used to do, they used to insert their data in the server computer. They used to save their data in the server computer. Ek server computer hota hai jisme sare teachers apni PPT, apna work, everything they used to save, right? And what they do, in all the classes they have client computers, okay? So they go to the classes and access their data on client computers, right? So I think most of you, all the students, know this architecture, right? Okay, so in client server computer, one computer is having more privileges, right? More memory or more capabilities, and others are only terminals which are taking services from that particular server computer, right? Then we have types of networks. There are two major types of networks. So on the basis of the geographical area, we have two networks are given in your book. Otherwise, we have metropolitan area network also, PAN also, right? So here we are going to study local area network and wide area network according to the syllabus, right? So first, we have local area network. A local area network is one which connects computers and devices in a limited geographical area such as home, school, computer laboratory, office building, or closely positioned group of buildings. So local area network is a network which is limited to a small area. Like you can make a network of computer at your home, in school, or computer laboratories, right? Okay, so the network which occupies small area is considered as, is called as local area network. Fine, the best example you can see in your computer labs, where all the computers are connected to the single printer or single scanner, and all computers are able to use that single printer, that single scanner, right? Anyone can give the command from the computer, and that is executed by the printer and the scanner. ये आपने अपने computer labs में भी देखा होगा, cyber cafe में भी देखा होगा, only single printer और single scanner ही attach होता है number of computers के साथ, और आप अपने अपने seat से बैठकर, अपने place से बैठकर commands देते हैं, and that is executed on the printer or the scanner, right? Okay, so this is local area network which spans very small area, right? Then we have wide area network. A wide area network is one which covers a broad area, that is any network that links across metropolitan, regional, or national boundaries. The internet is the most popular when, I think everybody knows that internet is the network of computers throughout the world, right? So wide area network is the network which covers a broad area. Okay, and WAN is formed by the combination of number of LANs, right? Number of LANs joined together to create WAN, right? And the example of wide area network is internet, and you know that internet is spread throughout the world, right? Okay, now next we have, what is internet? The internet is a global system of interconnected computer networks that use the standard internet protocol suite to serve billions of users worldwide web. It is a network of networks that consists of millions of private, public, academic, business, and government networks. So internet is a global system of interconnected computer networks, or you can say internet is the network of networks, right? Number of the networks joined together to create a biggest network, and that is internet, right? And it is based on the protocols suite, right? So what are protocols? Protocols are the rules which are followed by all the devices which are using the internet. Okay, the most basic protocol is transmission control protocol, internet protocol, where transmission control protocol manages the transfer of the data from one device to the another, and internet protocol manages the IP address of all the devices which are connected to the internet. Right, so internet, it is a network of networks that, and it consists of millions of private, public, academic, business, and government networks, right? Now next we have World Wide Web. World Wide Web, abbreviated as www or w3, commonly known as the web, is the system of interlinked hypertext document accessed by the internet. With a web browser, one can view web pages that may contain text, images, videos, and other multimedia, and navigate between them by hyperlinks. Now, what is World Wide Web? World Wide Web is the collection of web pages, or you can say the collection of information data that is available on the internet. Now, take it is, take it in this way, internet is what? It is the network of devices, right? Or you can take internet as a box, right? And World Wide Web is what? This is the information which is filled in that box, right? So World Wide Web is the web of information that is available on that network, okay, which is available on internet. So here we are taking internet as a box and World Wide Web as a information which is filled inside that box, right? So this is the web of information which is available on internet, and you know that the information is available in the form of web pages, websites, right? Okay, next we have web browser. A web browser is a software used to view websites and acts as an interface between the user and the World Wide Web. For example, Google Chrome, Safari, Firefox, etc. Now, what is web browser? It is a software which is used to view the websites, which is used to access the web pages, right? If web browser is not there, we are not able to access the internet, right? So you all know that we use Google Chrome, Safari, Firefox, all these softwares are there. With the help of all these software, we access the web pages, we use the websites, we access the information which is available on the internet, we access the World Wide Web because of web browser, and it acts as an interface between the user and the World Wide Web. So web browser is what? It is the medium through which we can interact with the World Wide Web. Now we have the advantages of computer network. First, we have the data sharing. One of the most important uses of the networking is to allow the sharing of data, right? We can share the data on the small networks like LAN. Okay, you can transfer your data, your files from one system to another, as well as on the WAN like internet. You can share any data, any file on the internet, right? Then file transfer. Users can send text files, spreadsheets, documents, presentations, audio files, video files, etc. to other users. So we are able to transfer any kind of file with the help of computer network. Now we have the hardware sharing. Hardware components such as printers, scanners, etc. can also be shared. For example, instead of purchasing 10 printers for each user, one printer can be purchased and shared among multiple users, thus saving costs. So I gave you example also in your computer lab or in the cyber cafe, we used to have only one printer or the one scanner attached to all the computers, right? So all these computers are sharing only one printer or one scanner or any other device. We can also share the network in them, internet in them, right? So here, it is used for sharing the hardware. Internet access sharing. You can purchase a single internet connection and share it among other computers in the network instead of purchasing multiple internet connection for each computer. This is very commonly found in internet cafe, browsing centers, schools, colleges, companies, etc. So we can, with the help of the network, we can share the internet access also. We can buy only one internet connection and we can share that internet connection to all the computers in the network, right? Uses of network-based applications such as web browsers, email clients, chat application, audio and video calling, etc. is another advantage. Okay, if we are using the network, we can use the various applications which are network-based, like your Skype, okay, WhatsApp applications, and number of applications are there which are based on network, right? And we are able to do video calling, audio calling, and we are able to send our files on that network, right? So we have done that much in this video. In next video, we will do the further, right? Okay.